The message of tomorrow.
Tomorrow
you must pull two or three of your friends and bring here. Because tomorrow I am going to finally open up a discussion. I'm going to talk about the visitation of the cloud of Jehovah. This cloud, it will shock you, it will tremble you. After you realize that time has changed, when you hear that message also. Revelation 16:15. He said, behold, I come like the thief. And blessed is he who stays awake and keeps his garment with himself, that he may not go naked and be shamefully exposed. Ever since you received the garment, have you preserved your garment? In other words, the Lord is asking some of you, where is your garment? Because this is the hour to wear the garment. In other words, why are you not wearing your garment as a church in Finland? Because he's saying that you can lose the garment if you don't preserve it, you don't protect it, you lose it. And the confirmation of that is Revelation 3:18. I can read it right here. Revelation 3:18, I think it is 3:18, this is what he says. He says, I counsel you to buy from me gold refined in the fire, so you can become rich. In other words, the wealth you have in Finland, according to the Lord, it is not wealth. He said, you created Nokia.
It's
a big name globally. And you are known for your top hospitals, technology, and everything. Engineering, medicine. So much money, software. He said, but if that wealth does not lead you to the knowledge of Christ, then it is not
wealth.
Then somebody understood it. Do you understand what he said? Because he said, Revelation 19, we are reading, we read in the morning. In other words, our blessedness must be standardized based on entry. If the nation of Finland is known for high education, very educated, in this nation. Per capita, very highly educated. But the question then is, this is the question. How has that education helped you to enter heaven? Do you understand? This is very powerful. Because he said, you can receive the diamond and lose it. So I have come to walk the church in Finland to wear a garment and protect our garment. It says that when the church is not wearing righteousness, when the church is not wearing holiness, she is virtually naked before the Lord and shameful. Did you understand me, beloved people? What am I driving at? What is the point I'm trying to get? Because I know this is very big already. Everybody must now wear their garment. It must shine. It must be put on. I know. My bones are on fire. So everybody must now wear their garment. Because this has been announced as the hour for the garment. And when he says fine linen, bright and clean, bright, he means it is glorious. It must be radiant. It must have splendor. It must be bright. It must be without spot, without wrinkle. And when he says fine linen, bright and clean, when he says clean, it also means we cannot mix the salvation we received with sin. He said, clean, clean. There's so much I want to give this church. Hallelujah. There's so much the Spirit of the Lord is driving me to give, which is very rich wisdom of God regarding preparation. Right? Because when he said, bright and clean, clean. First of all, when he says bright, he's talking about the authority of righteousness. The authority of righteousness. He said that our salvation in the marketplace, in the public place, must be glorious. Radiant, like those camera flashes. And look at this now. He said also that because the church is the one that wears this garment, when the church operates in that garment, the rest of the world, they will know. And they will now say to themselves, look, the God of Israel is the true God. Let us go and worship him. He said, praise your God that the nations may see the goodness of your God and worship your God. When the Lord speaks from Nairobi Kenya in a healing service and says there is a cripple out there in another nation that is asleep. And then the Lord says, I speak life in those veins. And the grandmother is tuning on the healing service listening like this in Finland, more than 6,900 kilometers away.
Ja sitten tämä isoäiti säätää juuri sinne kanavalle ja puhuville luille sinne elämään.
You did not hear me.
Ette kuulet minua.
More than 6,900 miles away. Kilometers. And then that cripple wakes up and walks until today. Now look at this. Look at this. That is the life of God. That is the radiance of the garment, the radiance of the garment of Christ that we wear. Such that all other people, when they now see the looking for God. But there is no God like the God of Israel. So they will not worship you. Hallelujah. That is what I'm talking about the garments. That when they see that your life is holy, and in your workplace you are righteous, you are standing right, then they will say, no, this is the true God. Because this God that he is worshipping, that she is worshipping, has power to help him and her overcome sin. Ah, how beautiful. So, what am I driving at when I'm saying that you can lose your garment? What is really the point I'm trying to reach? I say Zechariah chapter 3. In Zechariah chapter 3, verses 1 to 5, he says, Joshua. He talks about Joshua. I can summarize for you, but let us read it, beloved. Isn't it beautiful to be here?
Yes.
I am very honored that we are here talking about eternity. The eternity of the church. Hallelujah. So, the Lord is so powerful. Let me say this here. We were passing through one of the airports to come here, one of the airports to catch flights. And I was worried, I was asking these people, do you know Jesus? Then they said, only a fool, do you remember? Only a fool. Only a fool. Pretend not to know Jesus. That's in an airport. Out there. So that gave me a lot of encouragement, right? That everybody knows Jesus. If they are given the right instructions, they will take Jesus. Hallelujah. So can we read Zechariah chapter 3? Verses 1 to 5. And I've seen revival come to Finland. But let me tell you before I read. In Kenya, the nation of Kenya, in this modern age, modern, when they heard this message about repent. Repent and turn away from sin. Can you say like I'm saying? Repent and turn away from sin. They wore a sack for putting maize and beans, a bag. In this modern age, beloved people, in this age, they wore a sack. But when you look at their revival now, you understand. They may have looked like fools. If you Google on the web, you find a lot of the sack people wearing bags, repenting. The way it was in Israel, putting ashes on their face. They may have looked like fools when they were wearing sacks. But now look at the reward. The reward. That's why I am encouraging you. Don't worry about the modernism of this country. Focus on Jesus. Because right now the church all over the earth is actually focused on the things here and the life here. why he has sent me to shape the church. To awaken the church. Said, look, your second year is coming. Be ready now. Zechariah chapter 3. Then he showed me Joshua, the high priest, standing before the angel of the Lord, and Satan standing at his right hand side to accuse him. The Lord said to Satan, the Lord rebuked you, Satan. The Lord who has chosen Jerusalem rebuked you. Is not this man a burning stick snatched from the fire? Verse 3. Now Joshua was dressed in filthy clothes as he stood before the angel of the Lord. And the angel said to those who were standing before him, take off his filthy clothes. Then he said to Joshua, see, I have taken away your sin, and I will put rich garment on you. Then I will put a green turban on your head. Then he said, put a clean turban on his head. So they put a clean turban on his head and clothed him while the angel of the Lord stood by. Then the angel of the Lord gave this charge to Joshua. This is what the Lord Almighty says. If you will walk in my ways and keep my requirements, then you govern my house and take charge of my courts, like these ones standing here. What is the Lord saying? What the Lord is saying is very important. He has sent me to warn the church in faith and all over Europe, that you may be born again and receive the garment of salvation. But if you don't guide it, if you don't keep it, protect it, you will lose it. Joshua here represents Israel. That Israel had a priestly calling. Israel was called to worship Jehovah and teach all other nations how to worship Jehovah. And so, when Israel worshiped correctly, focus on me, everybody. When Israel worshiped in the right way, then the glory came. This very cloud, the exact cloud, came down. And when the cloud came, he blessed Israel. And then he also defended Israel. Did you show them how the man of God spoke and asked the Lord to go and defend the borders of Israel? So you have seen it, right? Those of you who are here, you saw it. You saw how I spoke from Kenya and I asked God the Father to go and defend the borders of Israel, borders, with the powerful cloud of His glory. This same cloud. Let me give you some secrets here. Secrets. When I give the prophecy and the cloud comes to the meeting, And there is historic healings, people blind, everything is happening. Historic healings. How awesome. But at the same time, the same year, 2012, I gave another prophecy about the same cloud. And I asked Jehovah Yahweh. And I told him, Father, now you can go and defend the borders of Israel. And I said, he will go and defend the borders of Israel with the cloud of his glory. And the cloud will go only around the border, only around the border like this, only the border, only the border. And it is given me later when it is fulfilled. Even me. Later when I watch it in the news now, when my words are being fulfilled, I tremble. Why? Because there is another side of this
love.
When it comes to heal them, it is awesome, wonderful. He comes to prepare the way for the Messiah. His one and only Son that was crucified. But when he comes as a fighter, this is
love.
If you show them today,
show them in the morning, my Lord.
In the morning.
Yes, please.
It is unbelievable. Can you play that part? Just play that short part. Please read quickly. Do it in 2 seconds. Don't do this like that. Just do it very fast. Just that part where the cloud is going. Don't play anything else. Just that part. Just they must see. Then you see the other side of God the Father. That's why I'm telling you there are many things I'm not revealing to you. Play. Yeah. Look. Only along the border. Until the Israeli soldiers were shot, they began to take the pictures.
Jesus is
coming. Amen.
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 Jesus is coming. Beloved people, Jesus is coming. The same cloud. Moving on the Syrian side, but along the border. On the Syrian side. But only along the border. To fulfill every word of my tongue, every word I say. But when you move with the wrath, you saw the wrath, you fear. If you don't know how, what is crushing on the way. Did you understand me? Now, the same God. And that's why I'm telling you, beloved people. Let us keep the garment. Because Joshua here represents Israel. And they lost the garment because of apostasy. They began to worship another God. They received the garment, the priestly nation, the nation of firstborns, the nation of priests, the nation of firstborns. But then, when they did not guard the garment, they lost the garment. Now, the point I was driving at is that when you receive this garment and preserve it, then this is what the garment does. The garment restores the church fully complete. The garment of salvation we received restores the fall of Adam complete. When you check there,
seurakunnan sinäkin näyttää tätä niin leikkausmerkkejä, kirurgisen leikkausmerkkejä.
Like that lady in Kenya about 2 weeks ago.
Niin Kenyassa pari viikkoa sitten.
Big tumor.
Oli suuri kasvain.
And when I was doing the healing service by phone.
Ja kun puhelimen kautta tein
parannuskokemus. Connected to the radio.
Yhdistettynä radio.
I could see because the Lord allowed me to see. So I could see. I saw her in the hospital. And if you listen, it's on the way, you can listen. We do it live, so it's on the way. But when you listen, you hear a live conversation between Jehovah Yahweh and his prophet. Live, live. Because you hear me say, there is a lady I'm seeing you. You are here short. Right now the Lord is showing me your neck. Right now the Lord is showing you. You hear a live conversation between the Lord and his servant. Now the Lord is showing me your neck. I think it's a tumor. It looks like it's a tumor. And then he commands the tumor to dissolve. And the tumor dissolves in the Kenyatta. Kenyatta.
Ja sitten tämä Kenyatassa tämä kasvaa sitten.
Kenyatta. Kenyatta National Hospital.
Kenyatta kansallisessa.
The tumor dissolves.
Se.
The tumor was choking. She could not eat. She was only using fluids and was listed for operation.
Se kasvaa, se suli pois. Se oli niin tukehduttava, että se nainen ei voinut syödä kuukausikaupalla, vaan pelkkiä nesteitä nauttia.
The tumor.
Se vastaa.
Listen very carefully to the prophetic tongue and the voice of the Lord.
Herran profeetallista ääntä ja kieltä.
And the tumor.
Tämä vastaa.
When the tumor heard that you have been commanded to dissolve, heard.
Kun se vastaa kuulee tästä käskettiin poistuvan suoraan.
The tumor obeyed.
Niin se vastaa totte.
And dissolved. The next day it was powerful. When another doctor came to examine now, where is the tumor? Where is the tumor? You are listed here with the tumor. This is your picture for surgery, operation. Now the doctors come. In Kenya, this is what happens. Now the doctors come in the morning. Checking files. And another file, where is she? Go check her.
No, niin
the tumor, through gone. No. The doctor was live on radio, live. And said, we are shocked. We are shocked. And then I asked them, I threw one of their broadcasters, the tumor, and there is a healing service, and the radio is brought to the hospital ward. A radio.
Yeah, tuli kukaan äänityksen kysyä, miten usein näette semmoista, että kun on tämmöinen kasvain ja sitten radio tuodaan mukaan siihen, tai kun säteilytetään se.
And you come to the ward to check the file to do operation.
Ja se täytyy mennä leikkaukseen todetaan, ja sitten sulla on siellä kirjoitettuna, ja sä tulet sitten tarkistamaan sitä. Ennen leikkausta sitä kasvainta.
And you don't see the tumor that next morning.
Etkä seuraavana päivänä sitten näytään sitä kasvainta.
And you have to cancel the surgery. Cancel it.
Ja sitten pitääkin peruuttaa se leikkaus. Kerro niitä.
What do you write down as a doctor when you discharge?
Mitä sä sitten kirjoitat lääkärinä siihen?
What do you write?
Mitä sä kirjoitat siihen?
Because you hear that there was a radio in the ward, a radio in the hospital.
Koska kuulet siellä sairaalassa oli radio.
And they were listening to a healing service by radio.
Ja he kuuntelivat sieltä radiosta sitä parannuskokousta.
And in that healing service.
Ja siinä parannuskokousta.
The man of God, the mighty prophet of the Lord, commanded the tumor to dissolve.
Jumala
of your patient resolved without a cut, without surgery. What do you write? What do you write? That was what I wanted to know. What does the doctor write? So, when the garment of righteousness was given to the church, to restore the church, the garment restored the fall of Adam completely without one sign of a cut. Even now, for a while, where is the pastor? You're the one. By lady, where is she? Can you stand up and see you? I'm told you can even do the same like this. You are a pastor. I just want to help the nation of Finland. You understand the healing service I was talking about for the day. I saw your pictures on WhatsApp. It's tremendous with a big cluster here, and it was stuck. It was stuck, right?
Yes, the curtain was broken because the car accident.
So what would you do? Because I know, but I wanted to know.
Murto ja oli suuri kipsi siinä. Mitä?
She said, please don't forget me. Because my bones are full of fire. Because I ask the Lord. These countries are too rich. They are too powerful. They are so developed. Don't think you, this is unbelievable. Then I said, Lord, how will I approach them? And then the Lord now has found out how to approach them.
Celebrated them.
Then you will understand the importance of what I'm saying to this
nation.
When I'm telling you, preserve the night. Protect the night. If your employer tells you, you must do this, otherwise I fire you. Then you tell that employer that I don't need to be a genius. I simply know that between this job and Jesus, that is simple. I simply choose Jesus. That's what I'm bringing to you. Because of what I'm about to share, you will make sure you don't let anybody, to whether you are boss, to touch your life. Never. You cannot have it. In the Bible, in the book of Genesis chapter 6 verse 9, the Lord met a friend. He met his friend. Why? Because of this character called blamelessness. Genesis chapter 6 verse 9. What a mighty message to preach. And he says, Genesis 6 verse 9. This is the account of Noah. Noah was a righteous man, blameless among the people of his generation. Did somebody hear what I said? He says, Noah was a righteous man. He walked in righteousness. And when the Lord looked at him, he found out that Noah had the character of blamelessness. And because of that, Jehovah celebrated him. Oh, blameless. And because and the Bible says, the earth was full like this. And the Lord bestowed on them when he found Noah blameless. Beloved people, Noah became one of the big generals, the general of God. Became one of the big characters of the Bible. Why? Because of blamelessness. The garment I am telling the church in Finland to preserve. This garment bestows on the church, it puts on the church the character of blamelessness. And then it says, the perfect bride of Christ is mature, righteous, without wrinkle, without spot, and blameless. He adds in there. If the church in Finland are aware of this, there is a problem in this church. Let nobody lie to you that you can live the way you live, just the way you want, and enter heaven, please. Let no one lie to you. We must measure up to the benchmark, the standard of God. Then he says, finest linen, bright and clean, was given to the church to wear. Meaning, that standard of righteousness does not belong to me. Does not belong to the pastor in Finland. Does not belong and he gave to the church. Meaning, if the message of righteousness in Kenya has made the women to dress only long dresses and cover themselves with honor, if the message of righteousness has made the young men in the universities in Kenya every weekend evangelism to make to change them and make them to fulfill the gospel duty.
Yes,
and make them to remove all the phone numbers of God's friends. And now choose only Jesus. That standard is not for Kenya alone.